1984. He immediately found a prime spot for a hotel right in the town center, but there was a slight problem, that the land had already belonged to someone else, absentee landlord Nicholas Rudbeck. Friedrich didn't have enough money to buy both Rudbeck's land and build a hotel there, and so he opted for a rather unconventional solution. He claimed the mining rights over Rudbeck's land, which would in theory allow him to sift through the dirt for gold. It most definitely did not allow him to build a hotel on the land against Rudbeck's wishes, but Trump sorta just went with it. Fortunately for him, many of the rugged miners didn't really give a damn about his titles, or lack thereof, and so most of them either supported his venture or built on Rudbeck's land themselves. To add insult to injury, Trump obtained legitimacy by getting the authorities to add his name under the real estate section of the local directory. While business was good for a time, it soon became apparent that Monte Cristo's gold deposits were nowhere near as rich as people thought. The investors pulled out, the miners started to leave, and Frederick was forced to go looking for new business opportunities. In 1896, Frederick heard rumors that gold had been found in the Klondike region of the Yukon in northwestern Canada. Eager to seize the opportunity, he packed his bags and went there, opening several incarnations of his Arctic hotel and restaurant along the way, first in Bennett, British Columbia, and then in Whitehorse, Yukon. These establishments were located in one of the harshest, most unforgiving Arctic climates in North America, and yet Friedrich managed to transform them into local pillars of luxury. The Arctic Inn alone served several thousand meals a day and fostered copious amounts of gambling, drinking, and most likely prostitution. In 1901, however, the local government cracked down on all the illicit activities that made the Arctic such a shining success. By that point, though, Friedrich had already amassed a small fortune, and so he happily closed up shop and went back home to Karlstadt in Germany.